anti-wrinkle injections proven to change how the brain works. Little scary, isn't it? And this was the University of California at Irvine. As I take you through this study, I want you to think of the repercussions of not just injections to stop muscle movement in the frown, how it affects the brain, but also think about lip fillers, think about surgeries, body changes. We now know the injections change how the brain works in this study with a functional MRI, where they could actually look at sections in the brain and watch how they're working neurochemically. But think about, there's money involved in real life, so people getting positive reactions, not only from people walking down the street, but also financially as influencers on social media and all that goes with that. Also think about lip fillers and the positive reinforcement that people get when they get a little bit of lip filler and then they go a little bit bigger and then it spirals out of control. When we go through this study, think of that and how that applies to this one. Pretty fascinating stuff. Let's dive in. So again, UCI, and it was the modulation of the amygdala activity based on seeing emotional faces. I'll show you in a minute. Due to botulinum toxin type A injections that prevent frowning. That's Botox that we use in clinical practice. And of note, they did use 20 units, which is the therapeutic dose that we use in practice, and they treated the glabella. Now, many of you know that we use Botox to treat depression and sometimes anxiety. This will give you a little bit of feedback into what that's all about. Okay, so let's look at it. It's based on the fact that there's a feedback hypothesis. So when you see an angry or happy face, we normally contract or flex the relevant muscles to create the expression to assist in identifying and experience the emotion reflected. So if you see someone angry, you kind of frown, and if you see someone happy, you smile. It's a natural thing we do. So they investigated this feedback hypothesis using botulinum toxin injections in the glabella to induce temporary paralysis so you cannot move the glabella or this frown area. Exactly what we do in practice. They measured the functional brain activity during the processing of emotional faces. Now, there were 10 females that viewed pictures of happy and angry faces during these two functional MRI studies. Now, it is a small study of note, but I see this in clinical practice, and that's why I'm presenting this to you, because I believe it's real. So what they did is they showed these faces prior to getting the Botox and then following the injections. What they found, pre versus active modulation of activity of the amygdala, which is an area in the brain for happy and angry faces, as well as modulation of the fusiform gyrus. That's another area for happy faces. So consistent with our predictions, preventing frowning through the inhibition of the glabella muscle contraction. So when they predicted this would happen, because we know from clinical practice. And at the end here, when we're done this, I'm going to tell you a whole other level of this that we should be aware of. But as they predicted, the modulation of the amygdala and fusiform gyrus activity following Botox may reflect compensatory processes in a neuroanatomical circuit involved in emotional processing that is engaged with this feedback. These data contribute, here you go, to the growing literature suggesting that inhibition of a glabella muscle alters the neuronal activity for emotional processing. Let's take this to another level. So this we can measure with MRIs. It affects the brain. Anti-wrinkle injections affect the brain. Think about this. When people get their lips done, you know what happens. People want more and more, and they love their lips filled. They get positive responses from other people. That triggers something in the brain, and I think that is accentuating a lot of the body dysmorphic disorder, BDD, that we're seeing, and people don't stop. So we need to create awareness about this. It's not just that you can't contract here or that the lips get bigger and we like the look. There's much more to it. And now we know functionally in the brain, things are changing and we're altering not the structure of the brain, but the chemicals, what we call neurotransmitters, feelings, and emotion. It gets pretty scary. What say you of this study? Imagine wrinkle injections changing how our brain works. We know this clinically. Here's your proof. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.